church. We are waiting for the ceremony to start. Doug is in his new suit. Bobby Eagle Kraut and his bride. Say cheese.
No, no, you fix it later.
There, we're getting ready.
Dear friends, we are assembled here in the presence of God to join this man and this woman in holy marriage, which is instituted of God, regulated by his commandments, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in honor among all people. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and happiness of humankind. Our Savior has declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave to his wife. By his apostles, he has instructed those who enter into this relation to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, in honesty and industry to provide for each other and for their household and temporal things. Pray for and encourage each other in the things which pertain to God, and to live together as heirs of the grace of life. Doug and Kathy, for as much as you have come here to be made one in this holy estate, I charge you both that if either of you know any reason why you may not rightly be joined together in marriage, that you now acknowledge it. To be well assured that if any persons are joined together otherwise and as God's word allows, their union is not blessed by it. Let's please bow together for prayer. Almighty and ever-blessed God, whose presence is the happiness of every condition, and whose favor hallows every relation, we beseech thee to be present and favorable to these thy servants, that they may be truly joined in this honorable state of marriage, in the covenant of their God. As you have brought them together now by your providence and by your grace, we pray that your blessing would rest upon them. Even as Jesus was present at the wedding feast in Cana of Galilee, so now we ask that we might hear the soft sound of sandaled feet as Jesus comes and stands among us. We pray that your blessing would be upon us and that you guide us in this day. We ask through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Kathy and Doug are glad that they have found each other. I had the privilege of talking with them the other night, and to see in the midst of the stress of trying to bring together this wedding, still a joy and a happiness that was there, because they found each other. And I think it's by God's grace that they're here now, and it's God's grace that brings them together. They have both known pain in the past, the pain of the loss of a partner, one through death, one through divorce. And so they've experienced that turmoil and that pain. But now they know the joy of finding someone else. And they understand what marriage is about. And they understand the issues of partnership. They also have their children. There's John Neal, there's Chad, there's Elizabeth. John Neal, I guess, better known as Sky. But these children understand, too, that there's a blending of families that's taking place. But it already is taking place. And that which has been fragmented is now going to be put together into a new home, a new family that's being established. For me, it was really special to talk with them and hear their stories, and I hope to find out something about their backgrounds and how they came to this place. And it strikes me again of the grace of God that brings them together. Through the midst of the pain, through the midst of the turmoil, they now are seeing and experiencing God's redemption. And as I prepared for the ceremony today, my mind kept on going back to Romans 8. I'd invite you to hear God's word. Through the Apostle Paul, God says, "And we know that in all things, God works together for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. For those God foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the likeness of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those he predestined, he also called, and those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified." What then shall we say in response to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also, along with him, graciously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who is he that condemns? Jesus Christ, who died, more than that, and who was raised to life, is at the right hand of God and is also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble, or hardship, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sore, or the sword? We might add, or death, or divorce? As it is written, "For your sake we face death all day long. We are consumed as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." Doug and Kathy have both named Christ Jesus as their Lord. And we see now this marriage as an evidence of God's love to them, bringing them together. Doug, will you have this woman to be your wife? And will you pledge your faith to her in all love and honor, in all duty and service, in all faith and tenderness, to live with her and cherish her according to the ordinance of God, in the holy bond of marriage? Will you? Kathy, will you have this man to be your husband? And will you pledge your faith to him in all love and honor, in all duty and service in all faith and tenderness, to live with him and cherish him according to the ordinance of God and the holy bond of marriage. Amen. And give your flowers to him. You can turn and walk through the crack. Turn and face one another. Doug, repeat after me. I, Doug, take thee, Catherine, to be my wedded wife. And I do promise and covenant before God and these witnesses to be thy loving and faithful husband. In plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. Kathy, I, Kathy, take thee, Doug, to be my wedded husband. And I do promise and covenant before God and these witnesses to be thy loving and faithful wife. And plenty and too long, and joy and sorrow, sickness and health, as long as you both shall live.
As long as you both shall live.
The wedding ring is the symbol of the covenant that they're establishing. The ring is made in the form of a circle, no beginning, no ending, signifying the eternal nature of their love. It's made of gold, signifying the purity of their relationship. And repeat after me. This ring I give thee, in token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love. Most merciful and gracious God, of whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, bestow upon these thy servants the seal of thine approval, thy fatherly benediction, granting unto them grace to fulfill with pure and steadfast affection the vow and covenant between them made. Guide them together, we beseech thee, in the way of righteousness and loving and serving thee with one heart and mind, all the days of their lives, they may be abundantly enriched with the tokens of thy everlasting faith. Father, we ask that you bring them comfort and peace. We pray that you bring to them enough success that they know that they walk with you. But Father, as well, we pray that you bring to them enough stress that they would be driven back to you in faith, in love, looking for your mercy. We pray for the children. We ask for Daniel, for Chad, for Elizabeth. We pray that you'll help them to have your blessing as we mold together now. We ask that you'll give Kathy and Doug wisdom and sense that they can be a good husband and a good wife to each other, that they will be wise parents to the children. We ask, Lord, that you would help them through the stress even of this day, know now your blessing and your calling. Smile upon us and bless us, we ask in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now by the authority committed unto me as a minister of the Church of Christ, I declare that Doug and Kathy are now husband and wife, according to the ordinance of God and the law of the state. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. And therefore God hath joined together, let no man put asunder. Now Doug and Kathy, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you his peace, both now and in the life ever. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Doug Jock.
Yeah. the white.
Okay. Oh, I guess not.
Here we are at the reception. Turn around so he can see ya. Turn around.
Yeah. This way, okay.
There.
Come on.
Give it to her.
One.
Go.
Hey, you need to put the candy cane.